I mean, we was, it's my brother to this day. Mm-hmm. It's just the people he is in his life aren't the people I can be around. You know what I'm saying? And that's, you know, I'm no judgment to Chris, one of the most talented individuals.
And he cold. You cold. Blooded.
Yeah, and it's like, you know, we're going to have our reunion soon, but, you know, it's people make decisions in their life, and, you know, sometimes those decisions separate good fam, good relationship.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we going to talk.
So, you went through a lot in your career. Mm-hmm. A lot of people watched you. A lot of people say you know, you went through a bad, horrible thing, marriage, it was all across the board.
Everything was connected, though. And catch this. Why did I go through all of that stuff?
You went through a lot.
Because you denied.
I never gave in. I never gave in.
Because the same thing people always say.
I get where he's going.
Because the same thing they said about Jamie, that all of a sudden when he got sick and stuff like that, they said something happened, reason why all of a sudden all this bad stuff started happening.
Right. And, you know, my wife was a part of that. You know, she was in the business on a higher level than I was, just in my ex-wife, not my current wife.
Right.
So she knew the dark side of the game. I was still green. And once I didn't conform to the dark side of the game, mm-hmm. They was going to take me out. If we can't kill him, well, nobody wanted to fight me for real. No, and they knew, you know, nobody wanted to pull up. I was with the functions.
Yeah.
Still am. But I ain't going to fight nobody, but I'm still with the function. I will protect me and mine.
That's right.
At all times.
So I got a question, because when this, you know, the bad events started happening after that, is there any cause to say, man, if you had just da-da-da-da, you know?
No, everybody turned their back. You know what I mean? Like, we got him. We killed him. If you can't kill the man, you got to kill his name.
Exactly.
And there's no, you know, it was a hard battle to fight misnomers. And I wasn't doing myself any favors because I was hurt. I was going through a dark time personally from that.
When you look at it, everybody was talking down. Everybody, yeah. Your attitude, your way your habits were, whatever was, you said
alcohol.
Everything they could think of possibly. How are you still standing today?
Right. By the grace of God, one.
Man, that's beautiful.
But also the people that I have no respect for had the unmitigated gall to speak on anything my life, how dare they? And they're going to get their judgment not by me, but by God, period, point blank. And because that was strategic and karma is real, and don't speak on God's child, because watch what happens. And everything negative that was spoken is everything that has breathed life into me, to be honest with you. Not to prove anything to anyone, but to myself, to my family, and to God, that, you know, no weapon formed against me is going to prosper.
Man.
That's it.
Okay, after you guys did that movie, Stomp the Yard, did you and Chris Brown, y'all ever talk again?
Oh, yeah, we was tight.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Chris was tight. And I love him to this day. Shout out Chris.
Chris Brown.
Because this Christmas came after Stomp the Yard, didn't it?
Yeah, we did this Stomp first, then this Christmas. Yeah. And we kicked it all the time. I mean, it's my brother to this day. Mm-hmm. It's just the people he is in his life aren't the people I can be around. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
And that's, you know, I'm no judgment to Chris, one of the most talented individuals.
And he cold. You cold.
Yeah, and it's like, you know, we're going to have our reunion soon, but, you know, it's people make decisions in their life, and, you know, sometimes those decisions separate good fam, good relationships.
That's good that you're aware of that and know that, you know what, as much as I love you, I got to step back because this is just not a good environment for me.
Yeah, and you know, as he continues to grow as a man and evolve as an artist and evolve as a father, you know, everything going to come back around.
Wow, this Christmas, because I never really asked you about this movie, like, when you guys were doing this Christmas, it was such I watch it every year, too.
Yeah.
Every year. Yeah. 5 times, 10 times.
Yeah. He told me this is the only Christmas movie I want to watch.
I watch my boy Columbus, really more now, like, nigga, turn it on. That's what I'm watching. You know what I'm saying? Like, so.
They need something else.
Y'all got the number one.
Yeah, we got another one coming. We got something else coming up the pipe.
Awesome.
Wow. But how was it working with who else?
Everybody.
I know your boy was in there. What's his name?
Idris.
All of them. Like, how was it, to this day,
that was we were family, you know. I call Loretta anytime I see a ma, you know, Delroy Lindo, that's, you know, pops. the entire cast, Laz Alonzo, Keith, Lauren London, mm-hmm. Sharon Leal, Regina King, we were, you know, we had a ball. We laughed. Sometimes it was just hard for us to even get through takes because we was just being so crazy, stupid.
What's your favorite part in the whole movie?
Favorite part of the whole movie, honestly, was when we danced at the end. It was just fun.
I felt that.
We had a ball. That was real, real, real. It was last day of production, and we thought we was going home. They said, no, we're going to turn up some music. We just turn on the cameras, and y'all just do a Soul Train line. And we was like, oh, so we was ourselves, and we just had fun. That was, but the whole movie was great.
But it started off like that, and it ended like that. It was the same dance, and I know it was because you could tell the energy was the same.
Yeah, we had a ball doing that.
My favorite part. Guess what part is my favorite part? The part with Regina King.
I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah, I cracked up on that. That's one of my favorite parts. Yeah. Oh yeah, she got it. Oh yeah, that's class. That's cinema history there.
That was beautiful, man. So now, okay, when you look at all these Tubi, I asked FaZe on these, because I am on the Tubi. Like Tubi is Fox owns Tubi, right?
Now.
And it's growing. I know
brands. Scandal's on Tubi now.
It is. Wow.
They just picked
it
up.
What do you think about Tubi? I was just asking.
I didn't think about Tubi. Mm-hmm. I would do some movies, no offense to some people out there, you know, just to keep some change, keep the lights on.
Yeah, yeah.
That I would think was not going to see the light of day, but Tubi.
Picks it up.
Picks them up.
Yeah.
You know, you're like, damn, that movie came out. I didn't even know that was the movie.
I've seen a couple of them with you, and I loved them.
But they pick it up because, to me, you're a certain caliber of actor, no matter what movie it is. So for them to have that on their platform coming up, it makes it the platform look a certain way.
So then they reach out to me, and they said, "Hey, would Columbus be interested in ABC or Scandal?" Reached out to my wife, "Would Columbus be interested in promoting that Scandal's on Tubi?" I said, "Like what? An episode? No, the whole series." I said. Okay, I said, let me pray about this. But no, I posted it, and it's a good thing, you know, because now it's reintroducing the series to those that didn't catch it.
That's right.
And, you know, meeting the people where they are, it did wonderful for me, did wonderful for Carrie, it did wonderful for our culture to see, African-Americans are number one and number two on the call sheet on a network television series, but with high-level content, political drama, you know, high-level content, not just, you know, television fodder. So I'm excited for it to be on Tubi, and I'm excited for the residual checks. Run me that.
Hey, run it back.
Run me that.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.